This is Joe with US Sander here, and in part one of this video series, we marked all our wires and took the box off the Hummel motor. Now we're going to test it. Now, typically, testing consists of two different tests. First one's the smell test. If it smells burnt, it is. This one, I can smell right away that it is burnt. But there's a second test. If you don't smell burnt windings, you can test it with a meter, which will pick up about 90% of problems. You can still have burnt windings within the motor that won't show up with this test, and when you put the new box on, the motor will not run properly. Now, you take your multimeter, and if you have a continuity setting, that's this mark here, that's where you want to set it. If you don't, set it on your lowest resistance setting. With the continuity setting, that's equivalent to the resistance, but it also has an audible beep. Now, we previously labeled these wires, and we can see once we got the box off that the wires already had labels on and they match up with how we labeled them, which is a good sign. These motor wires are in three pairs. 1 and 11 is a pair. If we test this with the meter, we should show continuity. Two and 22 is also a pair. When we test these, we also show continuity. If we don't, we know that that motor winding is bad. Similarly, start and the other start should have continuity. So that's their first test. Those three all are connected together as they're supposed to be. Second test is making sure that they're not shorted to each other. So check 1 and 2. There's no continuity. That's a good sign. 1 and one of the start windings, still no continuity. Next we check 2 against the start windings. So that's our second test, and everything's good. If one of those was shorted to each other, that would be immediate failure. You know your windings are bad. Third test is testing it to ground. If either one of those three is shorted to ground, you'll have a problem. So 2, not shorted to ground. 1 is not shorted to ground. Start, not shorted to ground. So according to our electrical test, we're not finding any problems with this motor. But we know for a fact, because we can smell it, this motor is indeed fried. You can see here that this plastic is all melted from these windings overheating. And also the discolored windings here. See, it completely melted that plastic tie. And they're much darker than the windings here. These windings right here and through here were extremely hot, melted together. That's what we could smell earlier. So even though it tests electrically good, these windings have been overheated to the point where this motor will no longer run properly.